I am from New Iberia, Louisiana, and I went to high school there. Then I went to college at LSU in Baton Rouge, where I graduated in microbiology. I then went to medical school in Shreveport, Louisiana, and graduated in 2005. From there, I did my residency, and I actually started my residency in New Orleans at Tulane, but Hurricane Katrina came, and therefore I was displaced back here to Shreveport, which was okay with me because my husband's actually from here. And so it was a happy thing for us because I got married here in Shreveport during my intern year. So I finished my residency here and I did a fellowship in multiple sclerosis in 2009 here in Shreveport. Neurology is the study of the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. So that includes the brain, the eye nerves, muscles, everything that makes our body work. And what we see is patients who have had a stroke or who have seizures, things like migraines, things such as multiple sclerosis, dementia and Alzheimer's. That's been a huge field that has really expanded in the past several years. Unfortunately, more and people are being diagnosed with this, so we have quite a large population of those patients. I have a fellowship training in multiple sclerosis, and that is a central nervous disease where you get attacks in the brain and the spinal cord that causes disability. It is a neuroimmunologic disease, and it has come such a long way. Our first actual treatment for the disease was only in 1993, and at this point we have an enormous amount of treatments available for these patients. So I've been really fortunate to grow with this field in a time where there are more treatments, things that can really help our patients. So my treatment philosophy for our patients is to be a good listener. It's very important to listen to patients completely. They actually tell you the story. They tell you what's wrong with them. And I find that a lot of people are rushed nowadays, and even patients that come in feel like they don't deserve a lot of your time because they feel the rush and hustle and bustle of things. But sometimes it's just important to tell them, start from the beginning, tell me your story. So my philosophy is to always be a good listener to our patients, and I hope that they feel that we have been. I will say that I really still very much enjoy what I do. The day that that becomes a problem is the day that I'll have to say no more of this. But I really do like what I do because I can help people. Although I might not be able to cure what they have, we can help people in a variety of ways with our treatments and procedures. We are able to do Botox for migraine now that can really help patients. We're able to provide a variety of medications, therapies, those sorts of things to improve the quality of life in patients. The patients are so rewarding as well. I have seen patients with devastating diseases who have such grace, and they are just such an honor to be a part of their lives. So it's the patients that keep me doing what I do because overall they are very fantastic to work with.